Charlie Kelly here, local business owner and cat enthusiast. Is your cat making too much noise all the time? Is your cat constantly stomping around, driving you crazy? Is your cat clawing at your furniture? Think there's no answer? You're so stupid. There is. Kitten Mittens. Finally, there's an elegant, comfortable mitten for cats. I couldn't hear anything. Is your cat one-legged? Is your cat fat, skinny, or an in-between? That doesn't matter, because one size fits all. Kitten Mittens. You'll be smitten. So come on down to Patty's Pub. We're the home of the original Kitten Mittens. Meow.
What are you doing?
Clean my hands off.
What are you, a cat? Use a towel.
My mouth's right here.
I like cats too. I actually have 80 of them that live in my alleyway.
Too many cats. Sounds strange.
I have 8 cats that sleep in my sink.
Still too many.
I don't have any cats, but I sure do enjoy them.
Okay, now eat one of these. All right, you're going to want to huff a little glue and drink some beer.
This is cat food, Charlie.
Look, dude, I can't explain it, all right? There's some sort of weird chemical reaction that happens when you combine cat food, beer, and glue. It makes you feel, like, extremely sick and tired, and you're able to fall asleep.
Why would I want to make myself extremely sick and tired?
Because there's going to be about 50 cats howling outside that window all night long, and you have no idea how loud 50 cats can be.
Okay, maybe there wouldn't be cats surrounding your building if you didn't have open cans of cat food everywhere.
I have 50 cats howling outside my window because I have 10,000 rats running around my building, Dee, okay?
Stop yelling.
I'm not an idiot. There's a reason to do the things that I... Oh, I don't feel good. I'm just starting right on time. If I were you, I'd start wolfing that shit down. I gotta go to sleep. Oh, I'm not feeling good at all.
Okay, Dee. This little lady is a calico cat. All calico cats are female. I'm gonna pop this little girl on your wall here. She's gonna meet your little fella. They're gonna bond. And then I'm gonna rip her out, and he's gonna come right afterwards.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm. You hear that?
Hear a squabble.
Uh-huh. It's all part of the dance, okay? They do a little Come on, wait, hold on. They do a little... Crap.
All right, here it is. You go into the building. You run out.
You
get the kitties.
With the little box
the
of cats,
box of
right?
Cats.
Little box of kittens.
Right, and you save them.
You save them!
I save them from what?
Help! Please let me out. I have to get home. I have a cat.
Sir, we all have cats that we'd like to be playing with right now, okay? We're doing our very best.
My cat is diabetic. She needs her insulin shot. Please.
So we got to babysit a cat now?
Ooh, dude, I can't have a dead cat's blood on my hands, man. That's not good.
She's in a little bit of a mood because her cat got stuck in the wall.
Cat in the wall, eh? Okay, now you're talking my language. I know this game. All right, catch me up to speed here.
Look,
what do we got?
You're putting Cheeto fingers all over the wall.
All right, let's focus, Dee. What's the point of entry here?
That's the thing, Charlie. I've been looking all around this goddamn place. I can't find one.
All right, I've seen this before. You know what happened? I bet it flattened itself out, went right through a seam in your wall.
I don't think there's anything in the laws of nature that would support that.
Cats do not abide by the laws of nature, right? You don't know shit about it.
We're still gonna watch the movie, right, men? Yeah?
No. I think it's stuck in there.
No! It is not stuck. All right, let's focus on what's happening with the cat, all right? It made a conscious decision to go in your wall, correct?
Really?
Absolutely, absolutely. It chose to be in there. It wants to be in your wall, Dee.
Thinking about getting some catnip, and I was going to put
No. Don't do that. Don't do that. It's going to know that's a trap, Dee, okay? That's going to irritate the cat. Then it's going to dig itself down further. We may never get to it, okay?
You serious?
Let's start thinking like a cat here, all right? You know, we need another cat. That's
what?
What we need. Here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna crack a little hole in your wall, tiny one, it'll be cool. And then I'm gonna slip a second cat in with a string tied around it. Those two will become codependent, then I'll rip the second cat out, and the first one hopefully will follow.
Hey, man, I'm sorry, I don't mean to keep bugging you, but you didn't tell me what to do. You want me to start
care.
It now? You want me to wait? I'll wait.
Yeah, start it.
But I wanna watch it with you. I mean, I will
just
wait.
Start the movie, man, because I'm having a conversation here.
All day. All right, where are we gonna get this other cat?
I'll get you another cat. I got followed here by like 10 cats. Yeah. They're starting to follow me these days.
I don't want you to miss the setup.
Well, who's Agent Bauer? Oh, come on. You gonna let the stupid junkyard cat ride up front? It smells like it's been dumped in a bucket of piss.
Hey. Do not refer to him as a junkyard cat. He has a name. Agent Jack Bauer.
You know, it would be weird if you eat cat food to go to sleep and you have such a fascination with cats that maybe you glue cat hair in the back of your
That's
neck every now and then.
Information that you know, I haven't.
I've been trying to turn Dee into a hero by, like, getting her to, like, rescue kittens and, you know, compromising situations. You know what I'm talking about? But, like, she messes up every time.
Hey, what if we set up, like, a conveyor belt situation, right? Put the cats on that. And at the end of it, a chopping mechanism.
Oh, yeah! Let's chop cats!
No, let's chop cats! No, we don't actually chop the cats. Dee grabs them before.
Well, we'll chop a couple cats, just so that you know it's real.
Well, I don't think anybody's really gonna give a shit about a nobody saving a bunch of kittens or cats or whatever, but a celebrity saving cats, then you got a story.
So, lately at night, I've been forced to fall asleep to the deafening sound of like 100 alley cats tapping on my windows, trying to get in, you know what I mean? Thus, kitten mittens, right? I'm making a quieter cat. And then I made the sales tape when I heard about the merchandising convention.
Wait, but he's all tied up. How did you...
Let's not talk about how it happened, okay? It just happened. Give him his cat.
Dude, your cat's freaking
That's
out.
That's not my cat.
No, Dee.
Whose cat?
No.
Whoa, what the hell are you doing, Dee?
What's Mayor doing here?
What are you doing with my cat?
Your cat?
Yes.
Jesus Christ.
What is going on?
What's the situation?
I got two cats stuck inside this wall. Can't get them out.
You want to bring in a third?
I'm thinking maybe four. We have the means, the understanding, the technology to allow spiders to talk with cats!
You'll also notice that Mac and Charlie's flag is just a little weird. That's because their original name was the Thunder Cats, but they were confused by that.
Well, because we're not cats.
Yeah, we're not cats.
So then how could we...
Mm-hmm. Even though it's the name they chose.
You're saying, like, do the things you do, go even further with them, you know? Maybe get a ton of cat hair, glue it all over your body, you know? Walk around like a cat man in the night, through the alleyways, you know? And stop hiding the pigeon.
Chop, good.
And the cat's dead. I don't see any problems with that other than the fact that the camera might see my hand killing the cat.
No, Charlie, we're gonna pull the cat out of there before it gets to the chopper.
Yeah, but if Sweet Dee doesn't make it in time, you're gonna see me chop the cat.
No, just don't chop the cat.
Oh, I can't make that promise. Oh. Come on, I...
Whoa, where have you guys been? You look like shit.
I don't wanna talk about that.
Okay, first topic is cat food.
You wanna leave with that?
Mm-hmm.
Cat food.
Yeah, you find a can of cat food in the apartment, what do you do with it?
I don't do nothing with it. Don't touch my shit. I don't touch your shit.
Great.
Okay.
He doesn't touch your shit.
Yeah, that's very clear.
And then you don't.
So eloquent.
What are you writing?
I filled in half the can of cat food. It's sort of a half full answer.
Great. Trevor, your position on the matter?
I'd ask if the can is yours, and if so, would you like me to feed the cat?
Oh, see, now, he assumes that you have a cat.
Right.
Smart. He doesn't have a cat.
Yeah, so kind of a waste to feed a cat. It's not mine.
For me, it depends on how hungry I was. Or sleepy.
Oh, very interesting. Couple points for Frank right there.
Why? Well, I don't understand. He gets points for...
Eating it and then...
Well, if I was hungry and the cat food was there, I'd eat it.
And if you
If I couldn't go to sleep...
You would...
I would eat the cat food and go to sleep.
Because it might make you go to sleep.
In what scenario do you not eat the cat food?
I would always eat the cat food.
Yeah, no, exactly right. See, now there's a man who's thinking on his feet.
Actually, can I go ahead and weigh in on this issue and say that regardless of whether or not Mac does end up living here, you need to stop eating cat food.
Why?
Well, because you're not a cat.
I mean, look, maybe it's real, maybe it's not, but, like, look at it this way. Like, if a black cat crosses your path, do you spit over your left shoulder? Plus 9 equals box, all right? That's where the cat goes.
Terrible.
Does your cat walk around too much? Does your cat make too much noise? Guess who just found some investors for kitten mittens?
I told you, people love stupid shit.
Why do you keep calling it stupid,
it's
though?
It's really
Why
stupid, do you keep calling but people stupid? Are stupid, too, so...
Hello!
Hey, there he is! What's up, man?
Hey.
What are you doing
Very
here?
Good. Congratulations on the sale.
Thank you very much.
Oh, you were there.
Yeah. How much money am I gonna make?
Do what now?
Oh, the contract that you all blindly signed grants me 100% of the profits from any merchandising opportunities from your little bar and kitten mittens. I own that. Dude. I had to get paid by you people somehow.
Well, that's what the hooker was for.
Dude. All right, touche. You out-lawyered me there. Mm-hmm. Okay, tell you what, though. Let's split Kit and Mittens 50-50, and then you'll never see me again.
Wow, 50-50. Let me think about that. How about if I never see you again because the contract that you all signed also included a restraining order, which you're all currently violating.
And I was still in the dark. And there's only two things you can do in the dark. You can drink, and you can hide.
If you came to shoot me, at least let me finish my drink first.
I'm not gonna shoot you. What if I missed?
Well, then you'd have to say you missed me.
Maybe I did.
Maybe I missed you too.
Then you better work on your aim.
Sure, I could do that. But I'm better at close range.
Yes, you are.
Can I fix you a drink?
No, thanks. I'm sober. Plus, I saw you put cat food in it.
Maybe I did. Maybe I didn't.
You did, Charlie. I saw you scoop it out of the can, and it smells so bad. You're so close to me with that.
All right, I'll put it down.
God.